great Reverend Billy Graham reminded us years ago in his words. To get nations back on their feet, we must first get on our knees. So I urge you.
Yes.
In these challenging times of threats abroad and too much division at home, let's pray for America.
Amen.
For all. And on this one, I want to be clear, I'm not talking about praying for an agenda or for a cause. I rather like what President Lincoln said in his time when he was asked if he thought God was on the side of the Union Army. Our 16th president simply replied, my concern is not whether God is on our side. My greatest concern is to be on God's side.
Amen.
And when you pray, pray with confidence. I'll always believe those ancient words recorded millennia ago that Americans have clung to in much more challenging times than we face today are still every bit as true today. If his people, called by his name, will humble themselves and pray, he'll do like he's always done through the long and storied history of this country. He'll hear from heaven. He'll heal this land, this one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you again for the honor to speak today. It's a joy to be with you all. I know that with your support and prayers, with the strong support of leaders at every level of government, with President Donald Trump in the White House and with God's help, we will make America safe again.
Yes.
We will make America prosperous again. And to borrow a phrase, we will make America great again. Thank you very much. Thank you for the honor of being with us today. God bless you and God bless the United States.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Sing a song, if that's all right, then we're going to have our convention sermon. Sing with me.
Amazing Grace.